All right, so there's really no easy way to come out and say this, but like I...
Oh, shit.
That's what I'm saying. Like, there's nothing else going on. Like, what are you going to do? Sit at home, beat your dick, or are you going to watch C4cast?
Shut up and sit down.
All right, so there's really no easy way to come out and say this, but like I absolutely cannot stand both cats and cat people completely.
I was hoping for something else.
Yeah, that's not where I thought he was going with that.
I do not like cats and I don't like cat people. Like if you're a person that like owns lots of cats, like if you're a cat lady on like Tinder or something, instant left swipe for sure. I just can't. I've been traumatized since I was a kid. I can't deal with cats. So
I feel like that's not being fair to, I feel like you had one bad experience with a cat probably, or maybe two cats.
I'm convinced all cats hate me. let me rephrase this a little bit better though. I like kittens. I think there's this switch that happens where a kitten's cute and cuddly and nice, and then wherever that transition is between kitten to like adult cat, like when, you know, like humans go to teenage years, whatever the teenage year of a cat is, going from the kitten phase, there's a switch and all of a sudden they go from being cuddly, cute and nice to me to just absolutely hating me, and I can't do anything with it.
I think part of that is like, you know, puppies and kittens are meant to be cute. I think it's a survival thing.
Well, that's probably true too. But it's just weird because like the behavior completely changes as well.
A survival thing, dude. A fucking like coyote goes up to like a kitten. He's like, oh man, it's too cute.
Well, it's the we're kind of programmed to be protective of them, protective of cute things.
I mean, like, and Will, you're right. I've had, you could say one bad experience, but it's been multiple. Like literally every single cat I meet doesn't like me at all. I mean, when I was 3 or 4 years old at my grandmother's house, her cat, and I don't remember any, this is what my parents have told me, because I don't remember anything when I was 3. But the cat was sitting on the stairs, and I guess I wanted to go pet the cat, because that's like a normal kid thing to do, is to reach out and touch or pet or do something, right? And the cat was sleeping. And I guess when I went to go pet the cat as a little kid, I wasn't doing it right, or I just scared the living shit out of it. And it had claws. And so as soon as I went to go reach out toward it, the cat woke up, freaked the hell out, because my face was like literally right in front of his. And just took the claws out, took it, and just swiped straight across my face. And they had to go take me to the emergency room, and they thought I was going to lose my eye.
Oh my god.
And it was downhill from there. Now what's really weird is you think like after that experience, like my mom or my dad would be like, yeah, we're not gonna ever own a cat. Well, we owned two cats. I had two cats growing up, and neither one of those changed my opinion.
To be fair, I kind of blame you for that first scenario.
A three-year-old kid wants to pet, I mean, a dog would never do that.
Not necessarily.
Don't think so.
But, I mean, like a poorly trained dog.
Yeah, you can't train a cat. That's the other, cats are independent. If a dog is nice. A dog loves you. A dog wants to see you when you come home. Like I would come home and the cat wouldn't even give a shit whether I was there or not. It was like, yo, feed me and like shovel my poo and that's about it, right?
Yeah, I feel like this was not a cat problem. This was a, Brad is a loud, belligerent man. I feel like this was young Bradley coming in hot on this cat. This cat was asleep.
Just harassing.
Like, get out of my personal space, right?
Yeah. No, cat, I mean, you're definitely onto something. Like, first of all, I disagree with you that cats suck, but I will concede that they're definitely...
they're very independent.
Yeah, they're definitely more independent and certainly more ornery than the typical dog.
Yep.
But I don't know. There's some pretty chill cats, dude. Like there are some pretty chill cats
there's definitely a gradient where there, I would say that there's cats that are better than other cats, but to me, I don't like any of them. So there was one cat that I thought might've changed my opinion of this. And it was Naldo, Will, your cat that you got junior year. So our other roommate at the time and myself had girlfriends. And the only thing I could rationalize in my head was that Will felt lonely. And so Will decided to go one day and buy a cat and get a kitten.
Yeah, that may have been it. I don't know. I grew up with cats. Like, always had at least one cat in the house, maybe two, just depending on when it was. So I definitely had a, I don't know, like, desire to own a cat. But, yeah, maybe I was lonely because you guys had girlfriends and I was just chilling, playing video games.
But it was really funny because I remember you were like, oh, I'm going to go get a cat. I was like, okay, that's a little weird. And then, like, the following weekend, I come back to the apartment and there's Will playing with a little tiny black kitten. In our living room, and I was like, "Oh, he actually followed through and bought a cat. That's interesting."
Yeah, that was an interesting story. The local animal shelter, not in PG County, but there was one near where I grew up, over near Annapolis. We went there. I think I went with my brother and maybe my mom. I can't remember exactly, but we went there to look for kittens to adopt, and we were like walking around and I didn't really see anything that I don't know, that I like really wanted to get.
But did you go there thinking you were going to get something, or you just went to go check it out?
I think we just went to go check it out, and it was kind of the situation where, like, if I saw one that I really, really wanted or whatever, maybe I would adopt it. But I definitely was not expecting to come home with a cat, like, right then and there.
I think that's, like, the story of everybody who gets, like, an adopted animal of some kind. They're like, I'm just looking or browsing, like, they're window shopping, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I think they were having, like, one of their, I don't know, every once in a while the animal shelters have these, like, open house sales where they try to, I guess, get rid of a lot of kittens or whatever, cats. So anyways, we're walking through, and we, like, hold a couple and look at a couple, and I'm like, eh, whatever. And then this one cat, as I walk like by its cage, it reaches, and this is like a kitten, like a little fluffball kitten. It's like climbed up on the front of the cage, which is like, you know, the typical bars or whatever. And it reaches its paw out and just like hooks its claws into like the sleeve of my shirt and just like catches me as I'm going by.
Oh, really?
And yeah. And that was Naldo.
So it was meant to be.
Yeah, it was clearly meant to be.
The touch of love.
It was a touch of love. Now, to be fair, he probably did that to like 40 people that day. But
Will was the only one that stopped, turned around, and went and saw the cat.
It's just like dating, you know, you claw 40 people and the next one, and the right one, just sparks fly.
You know, it might be like dating, except my experience is just like my experience with cats, where, you know, the women swipe me across the face. So I've still got a ways to go.
You never know. Wait, you never know when that right claw is going to swipe you.
Oh, God. I can picture Brad's dating life right now. Getting slapped over and over again until one day he's like, you know what? That felt pretty good.
Oh, no, she's going to slap him and she's going to be like, I love you.
Oh, man. Hey, if you're out there, hit my DMs, right?
And slap him in the face.
But yeah, so you brought Naldo home, you know, to the apartment complex or whatever. And I was like, oh, this is a cute little kitten. And like I said, I love kittens. Kittens are cute and nice. They can't hurt you, right? They're small. But originally Naldo didn't have the name Naldo. So how did Naldo get his name?
I'm pretty sure he was nameless for like a solid week.
Yeah.
It was just I don't even remember what we were calling him. It was just like cat or kitten for a full week because I had no idea what like that. Because it's not like I had pre-picked out a name or anything. Like this was kind of a surprise kitten. But we ended up naming him Naldo because at this time we were like our entire group was addicted to FIFA.
Yep.
Like,
yep.
Everyone played FIFA. And there was a certain player, just this Brazilian dude, this huge Brazilian dude. I can't remember anything about him.
So this was also, just to clarify, FIFA, but the big thing in the FIFA that we were really addicted to was Ultimate Teams, right? With the cards.
Oh, right? Yeah.
So it was the cards with the card packs and assembling your team and then playing against other people, right?
Yeah. So there was this I think I had him on my team. There was this big defender, and his name was just, I mean, his name must have been Ronaldo, but everyone, he went by Naldo. And yeah. Lo and behold, we, for whatever reason, we were like, you know what? Let's name the cat Naldo.
Yeah, so Naldo, and I'm going to try to find this player again if I can go through the archive. But he was not only a defender, though, but he had the fastest, I think, speed rating in the game, too. Like, it was like 99. Like, his stat was like maxed for speed as a defender, which was just really funny as well. And your little cat loved to zoom around the apartment as well a whole bunch, right? So
yeah. Yeah, and the funny thing was, our apartment was all wood floors or like laminate. So he would go sprinting around, and he'd be like sliding into walls and stuff.
Yep. Yeah. And then so we weren't supposed to have animals in the apartment, obviously, on college campus, right? And so it was, you know, it's easy to keep a cat on the DL, right, compared to a dog. But he was there for almost half the year, I think, right before you finally decided to like take him home.
Yeah, he was there for a good while. And frankly, I mean, he got caught, or I got caught, I guess I should say, multiple, like I think twice. And they just honestly did not care.
Yeah.
Like, they never said anything to me about it.
The repairman came in one time and opened the door and saw a cat or whatever?
Yeah, because I would always lock him up in the bedroom when I went out. And he would always sit on my desk and just wait for someone to open the door so he could jump out.
Yeah, your desk was right next to the door, right? And it was like chest height or whatever. So if you open the door, the desk is like right there as you look to your right.
Yeah. Yeah, so he'd always try to escape. And I'm kind of surprised he never like got out of the apartment. Like
out of the front itself, door, yeah.
Right, because he was always trying to. But yeah, so he was there for about 6 months, but that was when he was a kitten, and he was so obnoxious. Like, this cat was so high energy.
He was clearly extremely high energy. Yeah,
he was clearly meant to be like an outdoor cat.
Yeah,
like he needed to go run around outside. So I ended up taking him to my parents, and they kind of like half adopted him.
Yeah.
Because they have a big yard and all that good stuff.
The girls loved the cat, right? So people say, like, you know, get a dog or whatever if you want to, like, attract women, because you can take a dog and walk it outside. But, I mean, theoretically, you can do, you know, kittens are cute. Anything that's cute works with girls, right?
Well, so there's definitely a cutoff. Like, chicks love dogs, puppies or otherwise. And chicks love kittens. But chicks probably wouldn't be, like, dying.
Oh, my God, look at this old 15-year-old cat. Yeah. So if you're in the kitten phase, it can work. So basically, Will, you got rid of Naldo right after the kitten phase because it couldn't do you anything anymore, right? No, I'm just kidding.
we'll go with that.
But it was, I just thought it was funny because I'm like, oh, you know, I had a girlfriend, and then our other roommate had a girlfriend, and I'm like, oh, Will got a cat.
Hey, man. Everyone's got to have a little love in their life.
Yeah. But that was great. And so you still have Naldo, right?
Yeah, he's my parents' cat now. Yeah. And my mom would disown me if I tried to take him back from her at this point, because he's been living with them since
for a while.
Probably 2012 or so. So 8 or 9 years at this point. And he is for sure their cat at this point. So
yeah. And Naldo hasn't had too much of a relaxing life either, right? You said he's been outside. He's an outdoor cat having some fun. But he's also had some trials and tribulations himself, correct?
Yeah, he low rolled the whole life card. So just quick story. When he was probably 5 or 6, so this has been a handful of years ago, he kept getting these kidney stones or bladder stones that would basically like clog him up. That like literally just clog him up. Like he couldn't pee. The first time we took him in, basically they went in and removed it. It was like a big bladder stone.
Yeah, but how did you know to take him in? Like, was he just like crying out in pain all the time?
Yeah, you could tell he'd like just sit in the litter box for hours. And you could tell he was just not having a good time.
Yeah, that's awful.
So we ended up taking him in. I guess they must have done like an X-ray if that could see the because it was like calcium deposits, right? So maybe the X-ray could see it. I don't know.
Yeah, no, whatever, that's true. I've had a kidney stone myself. Knocked on all kinds of wood. I never have one again. But yeah, they can pick them up on an X-ray.
Yeah, so they must have done an X-ray on him, and they saw it, and they ended up removing it, and they said he could develop another one, or he could be totally fine for the rest of his life. Well, like 2 months later, he got another one. And we took him back in, and they basically said, all right, this is clearly going to recur. Like, he's going to have this problem for the rest of his life. So we can either keep removing them, or you can just turn him from a he into an it. Like,
oh,
basically,
no.
Yeah, they were basically suggesting, like, removing his penis, removing, like, everything, and just having essentially a hole right in his, right there.
Oh, my God.
That would essentially mean nothing could get clogged.
So just a big enough hole?
I guess so. I didn't.
So he was already neutered, right? So, like, he already lost his testicles.
Yeah, so he had no balls, and now we're talking about removing his unit as well. We did not ask his permission. We went ahead and did it. Because obviously, I mean, you don't want to keep having to take him in for surgery.
That's the right call for sure.
Yeah. I mean, I guarantee you some people would not have, because it was expensive, honestly. Like, their surgeries were not cheap.
Yeah.
Some people probably would not have done it, but he was part of the family at that point, I guess.
So Pornaldo goes under the knife and no longer has his willy with him.
Yep, he probably woke up and was like, "What in the fuck?"
But that's just so weird to me because, like, he just doesn't have anything. It's just like a little hole, I guess. So, and he's been fine ever since, right?
Totally fine. It completely fixed the problem.
Jeez, have you ever found like stone chunks in the litter box or?
No, although I have never sifted through the litter box looking either.
That's crazy. Poor Naldo. Yeah.